Today is the last day of the CPPCC. Now I'm going to a meeting with other reporters from different media platforms who are working at the two sessions. And we're going to meet the chairman of the CPPCC. I've never been to this kind of event before, so I'm really excited about what will happen in this meeting.
稍微往前点，稍微再往前点来一点，一会儿过来，哎，这边这边过来。中共中央政治局常委、全国政协主席汪洋，13号上午在人民大会堂看望了参加全国政协13届二次会议新闻报道工作的。
I just finished the meeting. I'm still very excited.
After the closing ceremony of the CPPCC, the busiest square of these days has finally gone quiet. And I finally got some time to get a new haircut.
I'm now at the Beijing South Railway Station. I'm about to meet an MPC deputy, Zhang Tianren. He's very special to me because he's the very first person I interviewed since I graduated. But he never know.
真的吗？就是有认识我。拜拜。哦，张总，好久不见，我是不是您两会期间见的最后一个记者？
是，那肯定是。
走，我给您一会儿走。您今天那个议案就是有没有收到什么回复啊？
收到了。怎么说呢？这个一个是我有三个议案得到了全国人大的这个采纳，一些建议呢，他们都有一些回复。
好像有看到您那关于电动车的那个行业规范的条约。
电动自行车国家标准的实施以后呢？老百姓呢就感觉到一下子要改变他们的生活习惯，对他们的交通带来不便，所以说希望呢就是全国的有一个指导性的意见呢，能够让这些使用者啊能够是不受损失啊这个逐步的有一个过渡期。
那电动车为什么这么重要？
因为它是一个民生工具，又是节能环保，更是老百姓就是说买得起、用得起的这么一个交通工具啊。一公里平均只要8分钱的电费，作为还可以的这个，特别是对我们企业啊这个民营企业的一个是提振信心。
你有没有带什么特产回去？我们只要把精神的、把信心带回去就行了，这是最好的反应。再见了，再见了，谢谢您啊。It can be hard to step out of your comfort zone, and learning how to do that has been one of the biggest lessons for me here. Once you do learn the lesson, it's amazing what you discover and the incredible people you meet. I guess this is the end of my two sessions journey. Thank you for sharing this fantastic journey with me. I'll see you when I see you.